things I do not know yet. My name is Jenifer Bowen, and I'm the Executive Director of Iowa Right to Life. And I just wanted to come and share, Rod has asked me just a few moments ago to share just a little bit about what's going on in Iowa. And I asked if I could do that on the front end so that we can give the bulk of the time to the powerful information that Jim Sedlak is about to share with us. And so I just real briefly I want to touch on, many of you have already been back at our table. And what is back there is just an opportunity for you to understand the battle that we're in here in Iowa. We work very hard in our organization to provide information for you about the abortion industry in our state and what we're up against. And we believe very firmly that equipping you with the information will be the ultimate demise of the enemy here in the state of Iowa and around the country. So I want you to understand from the beginning that I have many copies of everything back there. So if you feel that there are ways that you can take it back into your community, whether you're here in Red Oak, or I know we have several people here that have made the trip over from Creston, take all the copies that you need, because we're here to really equip you to be better, not better, but feel more comfortable when you are addressing some of the things that that you will encounter when you start talking to your friends about abortion, and when you start talking to your friends about Planned Parenthood in Iowa. Hopefully that'll give you help. The next thing that I want to touch on just very briefly is where we are in the state of Iowa on our fight against webcam abortion, which is happening, as you know, just as close as down the street here in Red Oak. Webcam abortion is a fight that we have been lodging against Planned Parenthood of the Heartland since 2008. That fight has taken many, many different faces. Sometimes it's been before the Iowa Board of Medicine unsuccessfully. It was several years later, we took it before the Iowa Board of Medicine again after the governor, Governor Branstad, restructured the Iowa Board of Medicine when he understood that the former members there refused to even hear about webcam abortion and the dangers that we believed that it faced not only to our unborn children but also to women. And subsequently, in August of this past year, the Iowa Board of Medicine, by a vote of 8-2, voted to end that practice here in Iowa. Being the benevolent, kind organization that Planned Parenthood of the Heartland is, and as much as they care about women, they sued that decision made by the Iowa Board of Medicine by a panel of doctors and the medical community that when they heard what webcam was, when they heard about the more Planned Parenthood of the Heartland talked, the more they revealed themselves as an organization that just absolutely does not care about women. You know, when their doctors saying things like, well, I don't, whether it's in front of a camera or whether it's in person, I wouldn't spend any more than 5 minutes with a woman in an abortion. What, I don't understand what the problem is. The more they talked, the more medical professionals became very, very frightened about what was happening all across Iowa. Planned Parenthood did sue that. It's currently awaiting a trial, which will take place on March 28th. It's before a Polk County judge who has already gone on the record as being sympathetic to Planned Parenthood, who is a targeted organization by the governor and his administration. Not content to wait for that decision to play itself out, the Iowa House members, state representatives, those in leadership asked our organization to put forward a bill to ban the practice legislatively. That bill made it through the Iowa House in all of the ways that it needed to, very, very rapidly. The first night of debate on the Iowa House floor, they had a two-hour, some call it debate. I prefer to say that one party badgered the other party for 2 hours and mocked them and really gave away, you know, women need abortion because we know our limits, and abortion, or a baby might have colic, and that baby might cry, and we as women know that we need abortion because a baby could cry, and we know our limits. That has made its way around YouTube and around the nation tens of thousands of times as an unfeeling, uncaring woman who recognizes now that she probably should have been a little more careful with her words on the floor. It sailed, for lack of a better word, through the Iowa House by a bipartisan vote of 55-42. And now it sits in the hands of the Iowa Senate, and it will take a supernatural act of God, and we know that he can do that, to move it through the Iowa Senate to a governor who is more than ready and willing to sign that bill into law. Where we need prayer and the most focus right now in the next several weeks on that particular bill is that Senator Mike Gronsall of Council Bluffs will allow the Senate to vote. I mean, that's all we're asking for, is let the Senate vote. So we're right back where we've been a few times before in the last few years. So that's sort of an overview of where we are. I just asked Rod earlier, and I don't know if any of everybody in the room, I'm assuming, knows who Rod Goodemote is. He and a few others have been leading 40 Days for Life here in Red Oak over the last few years. And I just asked him, because when we pulled into town and showed Jim where Planned Parenthood was here in Red Oak, and we noticed that the sign that had been there for the last few months, sending girls to Council Bluffs, is gone. And now all that's there is the closed sign. According to their website, it's still active, it's still open, you can still take abortion clients there in Red Oak. But I think it's just one more confirmation, like Jim mentioned in the previous hour. It's just one more sign that we need that in the same situation in Crescent, we need that final, I believe, final push, that final show of you as warriors, praying pro-life warriors, to go out to those sidewalks and to that hill one more time. And I think God is really, we've seen it ten times in the last year and a half. 10 clinics have closed in the state of Iowa. The majority of those clinics being 40 Days for Life vigil sites. And so we believe, for a number of reasons, far too many to go into this evening, that God is powerfully on the move in Iowa and across our country. And as dark as the time seems, there's just so much more light, and there's so much more evidence that God is real and God is on the move, and God is in the business of saving lives, both in front of that clinic and in front of just every opportunity that we have to reach women. It's whether it's people showing up in community colleges and sharing the truth, whether it's showing up with our babies anywhere that we can. The truth is on our side. And God is on our side. I don't think I have any qualms about saying that. He's on the side of the author. You know, he is the author and creator of life. And so I just want to take this final moment and say, thank you. Thank you for your faithfulness over the last few years. Thank you for your faithfulness over the next several weeks. I cannot stress it enough that there is no way that we can do what we do in the pro-life movement without each and every one of you. It's hard sometimes to go out there. Jim was telling me of a vigil he went to in Anchorage, Alaska, Fairbanks, Alaska, somewhere colder than Iowa, and I didn't believe that was true, but he told me the temperature, and it's actually colder than what we've been experiencing lately. And Satan will use every opportunity to attack you in the next several weeks. He's going to use every opportunity to keep you from going out the door and praying it outside of that clinic. And I promise you that every time you show up, when it's hard, he will bless you in ways that you can't say anything but who but God. So thank you again. I'd like to take the opportunity to introduce you now to our speaker. We brought him in from, I'd like to say it was warmer in Virginia, but I hear they just got 8 inches of snow, so. And apparently they don't plow like we do. So we're just very, very grateful to have a man like Jim Sidlock among us. He is, as he mentioned in the last hour, he's been in this fight